Hi, welcome back to my channel. In this video we will learn what are SQL joins. So everyone knows SQL joins are used to combine data or rows between two tables or more tables. So in this video we will go through what are all different types of joins, SQL joins. We will take some of examples and we will see what will be the output of different type of joins. So as you can see, there are four main SQL joins, that is left join, inner join, right join, full outer join or outer join. So these are the four main SQL joins. So we will go through one by one by taking an example. So here you can see, let's first create two tables and see all SQL joins by doing SQL queries. So first we will create a table with the column 1, column 2, one is integer, one is varchar. We'll just create. So we create a table, table 1, and we'll just create one more table to do SQL joins between these two tables. Now table 2 is created with col 1, col 2, column 1, column 2. So we'll just insert data in table 1. I am just inserting these rows in the table 1. Col 1 is 1, col 2 is name 1. 2 name 2, 3 name 3, 4. So if you execute, we have inserted 5 rows in first table. Let's insert data in second table. We have inserted 7 rows and now we will go what are joins one by one. If you do inner join between these two tables, table 1 and table 2, as you can see diagram, this is the inner join. If you do inner join between table 1 and table 2, we will get the intersection point of those tables. It means we will get the rows which are matching on particular column. So in this is the query, select star from table 1, inner join with the table 2 on certain column, column 1 equal to column 2. If column 1 in table 1 is equal to column 1 in table 2, then we will get a result. So as you can see, here there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here there is 2, 2 times 3, 5, 2 times 6. So if you can see 1, there is no 1 in this. 2, we have 2 times, so we will get the 2 rows. 3, we have 1 row, we will get 1 row. 4, we doesn't have, we won't get any result. 5, we have 2 times, so we will get 2 rows with 5. So remaining all 6, 7, it doesn't contain in table 1. So if you execute this, select inner join, we will get 2 with 2 rows, 3 1 row and 5 2 rows. So these are the rows which are matching column 1 in both the tables. So that we will call intersection of two tables, table 1 and table 2. I hope you understand the inner join. Now let's go to left join. So what is left join? So this diagram represents left SQL join between two tables. If you do left join with table 1 and table 2, we will get the intersection rows plus the rows which are not matching in table 1. As you can see, in inner join we are getting the rows only which are matching of this common column, but here we will get the matching rows plus non-matching rows in the table 1. So we will see what will be the result. Let's execute select star from table 1 left join this. So we have got this result. So as you can see, in table 1 we have value 1 in column 1, but in table 2 we doesn't have 1. So we will get a row, but in table 2 we will get null values. And as you can see, 2 is matching with table 2, so we got the rows. 3 is matching and 4 doesn't contain in table 2, so we will get null values. 5, we have value in table 2 2 times, so we got the 2 rows. So we will get the rows which are matching, plus we will get the rows in not matching in the table 1, but in table 2 we will get the null values. So this diagram represents basically the left join. We will get the intersection plus the rows which are not matching in table 1. So we will go to the small variation of left join. Like suppose we don't want the rows which are matching, but we want the rows which are not matching in table 1. So here we are getting both, so we just need to remove this. So how to remove? In this there won't be any null values, so we want the rows only which have null values in the table 2. So we will just add where table 2 column is null. So this is the actual left join. Suppose if you don't want the rows which are matching in both tables, we will just add where condition table 2 col 1 is null. Suppose if you add this condition where table 2 column 1 is null, this is the column 1 in table 2, so wherever it is null we will get only those rows. So these are intersection rows, so we won't get these rows. As diagram shows, intersection rows will be removed. Let's execute and see the results. We need to get only the 2 rows, 1 and 4. See, as expected, we got only the rows which are not matching in table 1. Now let's go to the one more join, that is right join. This is very similar to left join, it is just a reverse of left join. So this diagram represents right join. So here we got the intersection rows plus the rows which are not matching in table 1. Here we will get the intersection rows plus the rows which are not matching in the table 2. So we just right join we will do. Let's execute and see the result. So we have executed the right join. we got this result. So these are the rows which are matching of column 1 between two tables, and these are the rows which present in table 2 but it doesn't have any values in table 1. So we will have null values in table 1 side. Previously in left join we got the rows in table 1 which are not matching with the table 2. Here we will get the rows in table 2 which are not matching with the table 1. It is just a reverse. So this diagram represents the right join. Suppose we got here intersection rows plus the table 2 rows which are not matching with table 1. Suppose if you don't want the intersection rows, it is same as before, we need to add a where clause like we added in this diagram. So just copy this. And just add a where clause which will remove the intersection rows. Where now we need to add table 1 column 1 is null. So before we added table 2 column 1 is null. Now we need to add table 1. Because here we will get the null values in table 1. So here we need to get only these two rows. Let's execute this and see. See, as expected, we got only the two rows. Now let's go to the next join. That is full join. Full join or full outer join. So let's go to the diagram which represents. So this is the diagram which represents full outer join. So it contains the rows which are matching plus the rows in table 1 which are not matching with table 2 plus the rows in table 2 which are not matching with table 1. So here we got only the intersection rows. Here we got intersection rows plus table 1 rows which are not matching with table 2. Here we got the intersection rows plus the table 2 rows which are not matching with table 1. In full outer join, we will get the combination union of these three. Union of left join, inner join and right join. So let's execute and see the results. If you do execute this, we'll get intersection rows which are these three, and these two are intersection rows, and these two rows are the rows in table 1 but not exist in table 2. These two rows are the table 2 rows but not exist in table 1. So this is the union of inner join, left join and right join. The full join is equal to union of inner join, left join and right join. So this is the small variation of full outer join. Suppose if you want to remove intersection rows. So in these rows, we'll have null values in table 2. In these rows, we'll have null values in table 1. So we want both, either null values in table 2, null values in table 1. But we don't want the rows which are matching. That means which have values in both tables. So we will just have a where clause where table 1 column 1 is null. So for getting this result, we will add a where clause saying that table 1 column 1 is null or table 2 column 1 is null. We want only those rows which have null values either table 1 side or table 2 side, but we don't want the intersection rows. So let's create that, execute the query. This is the full outer join. We got all rows. Now we need to add a where clause to get only the rows left which have null values. Where table 1 col 1 is null or table 2 col 1 is null. So if we execute this query, we need to get only this row, first row, fifth row, eighth row and ninth row. Let's execute. So we got the rows only having the null values. So that result represents this diagram. So these are all about SQL joins. The main SQL joins are inner join, left join, right join and full join. So if you see this diagram, you can understand very easily. So this is all about SQL joins. If you like my video, please like and share the video and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.